Hello, my name is Linda Geiser. I'm an ecologist for the US Forest Service. And over the past 30 years, one of my jobs has been to track air quality and climate using lichens as biomonitors. Today, we're going to be going to a variety of sites to see how air pollution impacts lichens, how it changes the species that we find there, and how it affects the ecological roles that they play. So we're standing here in a Douglas fir forest at the west end of the Columbia River Gorge. We're only 10 or 20 miles away from the Portland-Vancouver metropolis, so we can see some signs of air pollution on the lichens here. Some of the things that you see here look kind of scruffy and crusty. Those are crustose lichens. There's a greenish one here. There's some white ones here that look like paint. The ones that we focus on for air pollution indicators are the larger, the macro lichens, which tend to be leafy or shrubby. And we have four or five species of macro lichens to look at here. And the thing I'll point out first is that everything that we're looking at is an air pollution tolerant lichen. There are no sensitive species here. So that's the first tip off that there's could be an air pollution problem here. So honing in on this first one, one of the gray rosette lichens, you can see right here in the middle, there's an area that's faded and bleached and reddened. And that's where the algae have been killed. And this part of the lichen is dying. If you go up the tree a little bit, way up here we see another lichen. And this is a
punctilia.
There's a big patch of it here. And again, there are very distinct patches that are damaged. You can see how they're red and bleached looking, where the algal layer is completely destroyed. But this part of the lichen is still healthy, and there's another big necrotic spot here. And this is kind of normal that the damage is not even across the tree, but you see patches. From my experience, this is an effect of acid rain, where the algae are very sensitive to acidity. So we're here in the eastern part of the Columbia River Gorge scenic area, where the climate is much drier than some of the other sites we visited. And as a result, we have a different lichen community here, lichens that prefer a sunnier, warmer, drier environment. And one of the key lichens that we're noticing is this one here, which is called Evernia, or the perfume lichen. The other thing we're seeing here are lichens that are responding to air pollution, lichens that are here because there's excess nutrients in the environment that's deposited from fertilizing air pollutants like ammonia and nitrates. The telltale sign of that is the presence of these yellow lichens here. These bright yellow lichens are lichens that require more nutrients than you would normally find at a clean air site. And they're thriving here. There's quite a lot of them. There are also some more cryptic lichens that are responding to nitrogen as well. Another sign that these lichens are under stress is the condition of the lichens that are supposed to be here because of the climate, but are not doing well because of the extra stress from pollution. And so if you look at this lichen here, is some of the Evernia in very poor condition. And there's also more of it here that's in poor condition. So here I've posed healthy lichens on a branch stuck here next to lichens that are under stress. We're looking at three different lichens that are normal here for this climate. The perfume lichen, the shield lichen here, and this tube lichen. And in the contrasting branch, which is in poor health, where the lichens are in poor health, we're seeing some of the same species. For example, this perfume lichen is this brownish lichen here, but in very bad condition. We also have some of the pollution indicator lichens showing up here, this yellow lichen, and the white lichen next to it. which are an indication of nutrients and fertilizing pollutants in the air here. On this branch, we have a really nice example of species that are responding to nutrient nitrogen fertilizing pollutants. We have the yellow lichen, this white lichen here, and this red alga, the free-living alga. And the three of them together are indicating that there's loads of nitrogen at this site that's being deposited to this tree from the air. And the three of them tell you, without making a measurement, that there's plenty of nitrogen at this site. So you can read the air quality from a tree branch. We're in the Gifford Pinchot National Forest now in Washington, in a place with clean air. And you can tell that because of the kind of lichens that are here. Take a look at these long bearded lichens in front of you, hanging from this tree in the forest. These lichens are very important in the ecosystem in this forest. They're used by many different types of wildlife. They're used by birds as nesting material. Deer love to eat them in the winter time. The deer and other ungulates really prefer these, and they can be a bridge or survival food in the winter time for these animals. Other animals like flying squirrels and voles can rely pretty much solely on lichens in the winter time. The fact that they're here is an indicator in itself that the air quality is very good, because these are among the most sensitive lichens to air pollution. But what tells you even more is that they're very abundant here. There's large amounts of it. And not only this lichen, but many other sensitive lichens. Just by looking at the trees, you can tell a lot about the air quality at this site. Now we're looking at a branch lower down in the canopy, and we're seeing some more evidence of good air quality. And what we're looking at right now, it looks a bit like an oak leaf, but this is actually something called lung lichen. And the lung lichens are different than most other lichens because their photo partner is a blue-green bacteria instead of a green algae. And that makes them different physiologically. They have much higher requirements for moisture, which is why you're finding them lower down in the canopy where it's not so dry as it is at the top. They are also very sensitive to air pollution, and when you see them, and again in such abundance and so large and so many different kinds, you have a sure sign that the air quality here is really good. And that's a very comforting thought, because air pollution is harmful not just to lichens, but to many other organisms in the forest, to trees, to other plants. If you see that the lichens are in good shape and you have sensitive lichens, then you have some confidence that other air pollution sensitive plants are also doing fine. So let's look at some more of the cyanolichens, the lichens that have a blue-green bacteria as their photo partner, that are here. These ultra air pollution sensitive lichens, we have something here called a peltidra, which is kind of dark. Underneath it'll have veins. And then here we have what's known as the kidney lichen. And you're looking at these little brownish-orangish discs, which are the fruiting bodies of this lichen. Those fruiting bodies will release spores that will combine with blue-green, free-living blue-green bacteria and start a whole new lichen. And yet here's another kidney lichen without the fruiting body, so obvious. So here we have one, two, three, four, and here's even a fifth cyanolichen, all growing within a few inches of each other. This diversity, the size, the abundance of these highly sensitive lichens is a very good indicator that the air is clean here. We're here on top of Larch Mountain in the west end of the Columbia River Gorge at about 4,000 feet. We're in a noble fir forest. It's a second growth forest. You can see the remnants of the old growth forest right next to me, or at least one of them. And we're looking at what we can learn from the lichens here. And one thing you might notice right away is that there are no orange lichens, no yellow lichens, none of the little gray rosette lichens. So that means we don't have a problem with fertilizing air pollutants here. On the other hand, we do have lichens that represent a variety of sensitivities to air quality. So we have some tolerant species like this hypogymnia, or tube lichen, this hypogymnia physodes, and we have a little bit of the shield lichen here as well, which I'm going to take a look at, like right there. But we also have more sensitive lichens that we didn't see earlier, like the platysmacia glauca here, the tattered rag lichen, and its cousin, the Norwegian tattered rag. And then we also have platysmacia stenophylla here. So we have quite a few different species. So overall, what we're seeing is healthy growth of lichens. We're not seeing that it's limited only to tolerant species. We're seeing a variety of sensitivities among the lichens that are here, and we're seeing a little bit of a beard lichen. So we can put this at the cleaner end of the air quality gradient compared to a couple of the other sites that we've been to here.